So you know what that umbrella guy absolutely adores? The fact that certain people out there, they love content so much that they got to go out there and express it. Yeah, that's what they're doing. They're expressing love. That's what we've been getting lately from either AH or some AH followers. Although I'm going to make the case it could be AH themselves. But yeah, let's get right into that. So hey there, so today you and I, we are returning to that wonderful, wonderful world of salt mines. And speaking on salt mines, I want to correct this article from the American Mine Services. Why? Because it lists the top 10 largest salt mines in the world. And all of this, it's either wrong, you know, there's a typo, misprint or something here, or this is outdated information. Why? Because right now, I think we're living on the biggest one out there, if I'm being honest. When you walk without rhythm, you still attract the bot. Now, as far as platform love taps are concerned, been there, done that, supersized it. As far as Reddit, for example, can't be on quite a few places on Reddit because, oh my god, one of those pesky gators. As far as Facebook is concerned, not allowed to be on there either, even though I've never posted anything objectionable, even close to that. Twitter, been suspended from there twice. And this place, well, I've gotten love taps for a lot of things. The one thing that I've never had, though, was a thumbnail targeted, at least not until now. Now, the funny thing about this specific thumbnail is it was approved by a human moderator. That's right. The video that I did, it talked about Amber Heard, which is an automatic demonetization for review. So I put it through review and they managed to give it to me. Let me say, too, they would not give it to me if it was objectionable in any way, shape, or form, in imagery or wording. But yeah, they decided they would. Now, this image, too, this is not copyrighted in any way, shape, or form. They would have noted that if it would have actually triggered something in the copyright. Oh, no, they were saying that it's objectionable. But the only reason it's objectionable is because somebody went in, flagged it, probably mass flagged it, too. Now, as far as that flag goes, you and I, we will examine it in close detail in just a moment. Why? Because it is a monument to salt. I mean, again, the thing is crafted 117% from it. But before we do, I want to add this. Typically, I wouldn't associate a specific name with who did that. I might say that the topic was about them. Therefore, their supporters, they might be responsible. And AH's supporters, oh yeah, I could see it. But knowing that person, I would say typically they're not responsible. AH, however, yeah, I don't give her the benefit of the doubt, and for two reasons. The first reason here, it comes from defendant AH's memorandum in support of her motion for sanctions against Adam Waldman, counsel for plaintiff. Now, what's important about this? Proof that she pays attention to YouTubers. They pay quite a bit of attention. If you notice all of these footnotes here, you'll notice twitter.com/thatBrianFella. Here's another one from the same place. Another one from the same place and on. They're talking about the YouTuber Incredibly Average, and they've brought him up so many times now. You know that they talk about him behind the scenes, and they talk about him quite a bit. Now, our second example also hails from that luscious world of court documentation. You see why I like going through this stuff, because you find some fascinating stuff, including this. Now, this, it basically is AH saying there's an army of bots out here. They're ran by Johnny Depp and Johnny Depp's lawyers, and they talk about specific accounts that they've been tracking. Now, listen to how crazy this sounds, too, because, I mean, these are just Twitter users that they don't like. Quote, two accounts, IFOD, Net, and Mike Grindenwald, are responsible for approximately 50% of the, we're just going to say, accosting of AH. My Grindenwald account uses its platform to amplify anti-AH hashtags and false information being disseminated about AH. It has also amplified the change.org petition described above, repeating calls for AH to lose contracts or business expectancies. And as evidence of its origin, it routinely tweets the statements of Mr. Depp's agent and attorney, Mr. Waldman, on a near daily basis, and oftentimes praises the otherwise unknown attorney, even going so far as to say, I love you, Waldman. I mean, think about how much they're tracking just random users. If that's not enough, too, look at this. This is a list of random Twitter users that had the audacity to back Johnny Depp while also being critical or hypercritical of AH. Now, what's fascinating about this is that most of them are not prolific Twitter users. Many of them are just run-of-the-mill Twitter users. They don't make videos. They don't do anything like that. So, if AH and her team would target them, don't you think they would be keeping up with things like, I don't know, again, YouTube videos and on? Again, I don't know that they're responsible for this kind of stuff, but I know the targeting has increased. It has increased over months now, and well, I wouldn't put it past them at all. And that, it brings us to our wonderful, wonderful message from the platform. Hi, that umbrella guy. Well, hey there in return. The following video or videos have been flagged for their thumbnails. The thumbnails have been reviewed and removed, so they tell you this is the newest one. By the way, I'm sure that they try to flag all the videos too, but that doesn't work so well anymore. Why doesn't it work, by the way? Well, because they've tried that so many times. I've appealed that, and I've actually had stuff restored. Now, as mentioned, we've removed your content because we think it violates our community guidelines. You can find specific information about these guidelines in the YouTube Help Center. So basically, they just give you this nebulous return, you know, saying it violates something. What does it violate? Well, we don't really know, and we're not going to tell you. Now, this is where a huge problem comes in, by the way. Please note that let's just say to the beer bug, a number of our normal review processes have been disrupted. You can read more about that here. In an effort to prioritize the well-being of our employees, our extended workforce, and the communities where they live, we rely less on human reviewers and more on automation alone to make decisions. As a result, some content may get removed in error. Yes, dozens of things, by the way, but hey, fun times. If you think this removal was an error, I do, and I've appealed it, please appeal using the form below, and we'll get back to you as resources allow. Note that we will also be slower to respond to appeal requests. We apologize for these disruptions. Taking these workplace precautions is the right thing to do for the people who work and keep YouTube safe for the broader community. We appreciate everyone's patience as we take steps during this challenging time. This was not a strike on your account, by the way. You can re-upload a thumbnail. If you think that was a mistake, you can appeal. Yeah, the only thing is that in the process, you have to make something new. You have to throw something up there right away. And of course, that's disruption. It causes problems. But hey, the salt melange must flow. Yeah, I've been listening to a lot of Dune lately, trying to get ready for the new movie. But anyway, let me know what you think. As always, I appreciate the heck out of you folks too. You make this endeavor work. And you know what? This isn't complaining. It's just laughing at the absurdity of it. If you want to help out the channel too, there are links in the description. Those include memberships, Patreon, and also our comic book. Our comic book could use help too, because we're wrong thinkers. It's in process right now, meaning we are finalizing things. Yeah, check that sucker out. And again, as always, thank you.